Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Craig here from Video Juice, and we are here with the Supernatural Season 12 finale. Sad face. Last time in Supernatural, we had a great penultimate episode. Technically, the first half of the episode. This is technically like the second half of the finale, because they stuck them together for a double finale. So last time, the British Melonetters got taken down. Sam mobilized the Hunters and led all of them to go take out the British Melonetters, which they did. Sam, with the help of Tony, went into Mary's mind to try and fix her brainwashing shite, and he did. Ketch interrupted it, got killed by Mary. British Melonetters got taken down, and the head one, I can't remember her name, the head girl, woman, she got taken out by Jody. Sam did lose a few of the Hunters, they did get taken out. We got confirmation that Garth and Claire are still alive. Lucifer is looking for the Nephilim, his child. His child is with Cass and Mary. Crowley is a wild card because he is presumed dead by everyone on the show, but we know he's not. He's in a rat, which means he's a wild card. He's going to pop back up later. And the interesting thing about that is he could go back and get his vessel, but he probably won't if he's going to pop back up again. He might pop back up in a different vessel, so we probably won't know who he is. Or he could go and get his vessel and pop back up then. It could go either way. I do think Crowley will be the wild card, though, in this episode. He will be the pop back up and help when everyone else thinks they're down and out, maybe. The only thing I'm really hoping for in this episode is that Garth pops back up, but it's a slim chance. I don't think he will. I think if he was going to pop back up, it would have been last episode. So, last episode was crazy good. So, I'm not going to talk very much now. So, we're just going to jump in, check it out, see what it's like, discuss it afterwards. Let's do this.
Did you know?
Here's the song.
Stories about us?
Yeah.
Wayward?
A little bit legendary.
Yes! This is one of my, I look forward to this every single season. It's one of my favorite parts of Supernatural. The Wayward Son recap video. Rest, cry no more.
God, please. I need help.
I'm trying to help you, ma'am.
Are you? Sven, because if you ask me if I have the quarter inch Allen wrench one more time, I'll beat you. Go down there and burn your.
There's a nice little twist.
Viking junkyard of a store to the ground.
Yeah. Are they really doing a big reveal here? It wasn't done very well. They wanted to make us think he was dead. They shouldn't have shown the rat. All right. Is he going back down to get his vessel? Yeah, he is. He's back.
We don't need Crowley. We need Roman.
That's cool. It was really reminiscent of Dean coming out of hell.
Right, so where is she?
Oh!
Oh, hey, Sammy.
What?
Go to hell.
Ooh, good one. Wait a minute, I'll use it in the future.
Alright, well, I'd love to chat with you. Which bitch gone? You can't put me back in the cage, so, like I said.
Oh, shit.
Matter.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
How would they kill him?
Thank you.
Supercharged cast, maybe, with the Nephilim power, but I don't know if that would be strong enough. God and the darkness could intervene.
I disagree. I have read 74 books on child rearing, and there is one thing that they all agree on. Everybody poops.
Well, you're not wrong.
Oh.
I'm fine.
It's nearly time.
I'm fine.
Oh! Whoa!
Yeah, story of our lives.
What's it gonna do? Looks like a little portal kind of thing. Don't touch it! Whoa! Is he in hell? That looks like a body on a spike. Fucking was a portal. It can't be hell, I don't think. Whoa. Oh, he looks cool. What is happening here? Who is it? It's not Rufus, is it? Is it actually? Say it. Damn it! There's my pen.
I know you're gonna be okay.
Could it be their father?
You are gonna be.
I should have looked at the skin color.
Amazing.
Damn it.
Whatever this thing is gonna be, it's gonna be big and bad.
You rang?
Oh!
Hello, boys.
Did you do it? Seriously?
Seriously?
Well, just don't kill him. He worked the cage spell with Rowena. Maybe he can help us.
And what if he can't?
Well, then we kill him.
Yes.
I'll seal the gates of hell. You'll never see another demon again. Apart from, of course, yours truly.
Oh.
You would do that.
Why not? They stabbed me in the back. I'll happily stab them in the front, the sides, and right up the little black-eyed asses. So.
Oh, shit. Start what they finished a few years ago.
Cass?
Or finish what they started a few years ago. Got that completely backwards.
That's what you do when I'm not here. Tight.
Yep. I won James Novak.
That's Cass.
Jimmy Novak.
Let's roll.
It's about time.
Oh.
Sit down and shut up.
Why would they leave the knife there? Surely he can pull it out, right? That's odd. Damn it. They know how to keep us waiting.
I saw the future.
Oh, are they gonna show us? Come on.
I saw a world without pain and without suffering and without hate.
Hmm.
I saw paradise.
Right.
So oh, are they gonna see it? Oh.
What is that?
We're gonna get an explanation now.
But different. It's an alternate reality.
Alternate.
So it's a bizarro world. Or like the place we got zapped to where we were actors on a TV show.
Oh, yeah, the supernatural wasn't real.
Yeah.
And you were Polish?
Right.
You don't want to know.
Was it the apocalypse?
Probably. But we need to.
Oh.
It's Earth.
But this Earth is locked in eternal war between heaven and hell. There are armies of angels fighting hordes of demons, and the few humans that remain are caught in between.
Whoa.
How do you know that?
A friend told me.
Sounds right.
What if they get trapped in there for next season?
You open this door. We'll close it.
That'd be interesting. Oh, shit.
Guys.
Who is it? Could it be John? I don't think they'd get the actor back. I don't think they could. Or is it Sam or Dean? Bobby!
He's dead. Been dead over 40 years now.
Oh, shit.
The only reason I know about him is this hunter I ran with, Mary Campbell. He did a few pints of shine into her.
This is a world where you were never born.
She didn't make the deal with Azazel.
It's a world you never saved.
Pretty much peaches and cream on your side.
Oh my god, is he gonna come over?
That. It's better than this. And when they show, me and Rufus go to work.
Oh.
He's loaded with 100 rounds.
Wait, angel killing bullets?
Awesome.
Yeah, it is. Oh man, please bring this Bobby back.
Well,
this is a fun surprise.
Oh shit, face to face.
Enough with the foreplay.
Let's do this.
Here we go.
See you on the other side, boys.
Are they going to push him through? Shit.
Mature. Real mature. Guys, I really want to enjoy this.
Oh, it's all planned.
Saber just ripping you apart. I'm on the clock. Interesting.
Okay.
Ziva works against an archangel.
Oh, the bullets!
Say hello to my little friend.
There's no way it's gonna work.
Come on now, Crowley, come on.
They have a plan though.
We need one more minor ingredient.
Why does Dean always get to take the beans? Shit. It's like part two. Follow on from season 5. Oh shit. Crowley's.
Surprise.
Crowley v Lucifer.
Bye, boys.
What? Oh! What's he doing? It's gonna close. Oh! Don't close. Yes!
Yes.
No!
I've heard about you. You,
what's she have behind her back?
Look, seriously, I just wanted to say thank you. I owe you, kid.
Oh, is Mary gonna kick the shit out of it, Lucifer?
I love you.
Oh, he's gonna drag her in! He's angry. He lost. Fuck, what's he gonna do to Mary?
No, 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 no.
Oh. Don't end. No. I don't know where to start. This is just so, for a second we have Bobby came back, Rowena apparently dead, Cass apparently dead, Crowley apparently dead, half the fucking hunters from last episode apparently dead, Lucifer and Mary in another dimension. What? I don't think they're all gonna stay dead. Crowley might. Crowley's seemed like a fitting end for the character, you know. I don't know if they would kill off Cass and Crowley in the same season or episode. You see, with the alternate dimension now, or the alternate universe, with the alternate universe now, they could potentially bring them back, but alternate versions of themselves. But that's a different character. It's not the same character. So it's still means they're dead. I mean, keeping the actor around. I don't know. It was a good episode. It's one of my favorite season finales for a while. It was structured so differently than the other seasons. That's what kind of jumped out at me first. Like all the other seasons, Supernatural has always been a very formulaic show, which is fine. It gets it done. Season 1 to 5 are phenomenal. Like, but they always have like set up a big bad in the previous season, and that's what they battle throughout. Blah blah blah. last few episodes are them trying to sort it out. But I like that this one, like, they didn't even know about Lucifer until the last episode. I know he wasn't technically the big bad of the show, but like there technically wasn't a big bad. The British Men of Letters kind of came into that role later on in it, but and then Lucifer in the last episode. But I like that there wasn't like a massive big overall big bad. It mixed it up a bit. I liked the shot of Crowley digging out of the grave. It was very reminiscent of Dean from season 4, coming up out of the grave after being in hell for a year, a year normal time. So that was. I just thought I'd mention that. That was cool. So Rowena is dead. That was It's. I'm a bit disappointed that she didn't get another, because we haven't seen her in so long. I'm disappointed we didn't get another last scene with her. Entering in the alternate universe makes it interesting, because you can bring back the actors, but the characters you can't really bring back. I mean, it was a bold move. Cast Rowena, Crowley, Mary Lucifer over there. It's a lot of, not main characters, but like fan favourites. Well, except for Rowena, I suppose. I loved the demon design on the demon in the other dimension. What did they call it? A tempter demon. I thought that was cool. It was like a, classic demon design, basically. You know, the horns and stuff. I just thought I'd mention it was cool. If this is the end of Crowley, I would be okay. Crowley is the one that I would be okay with being gone. I love Crowley. He's a good character. He's been fun. I liked his interactions with the Winchesters over the years, and their growing relationship. It was really fun. But I mean, what more can he do realistically? You know, he's had a long run. He's gone through everything, and he expressed being sick of ruling hell. So, and he was planning on closing the gates as well. I suppose that's off the table now. Now that he is dead. And I wrote it down just because it seemed weird, but why did Dean think stabbing Crowley in the hand was going to stop him from leaving? Can't he just like pick it up? Because Ruby had the blade originally, which means like it doesn't hurt him when they hold it. So all he had to do was pull it out, and then he was grand. So it seemed a bit weird that Dean did it first of all, thinking it would keep him there, and then that they were shocked when he got out. You know, it was a bit weird. Oh, seeing Bobby again. It was so good. I thought it was Rufus, because Rufus always had that that combat shotgun, and I loved that he named his gun after Rufus. That was cool. It was just nice seeing him again. I hope bringing this alternate dimension into it, or alternate universe, I keep calling it an alternate dimension. I suppose any of them would work. I hope bringing this into it, that next season they can go that little bit wacky with the cameos and have all these old cameos again from old characters. It's such a great opportunity, but I don't know how. I mean, they could do it, obviously, with a few characters. Some characters they probably wouldn't be able to. It's such a good opportunity to do something like that. So that other world became like that because the Winchesters were never born. So does that mean that Mary said no to Azazel? She didn't sacrifice her life. But then, I don't know. Maybe. Angel bullets got introduced. I have no doubt they are going to be kept in. I don't know why they didn't think of that sooner. Melt down the angel blade. They'd have to find a method to melt it down, unless it just melts normally anyway. But melt down the angel blade, put it into bullets. That was a good revelation. Obviously, they're setting that up for next season. Like, they obviously introduced it now for a reason. Obviously, if they cross over, it'd be interesting if they crossed over into the alternate universe, find a way to open it again and cross over there to get Mary back, and they have to use the angel bullets over there, because it's a war on Earth, heaven v hell. But they have to deal with the Nephilim now, so I don't know how that would work. The Nephilim seemed interesting. I wonder, he aged in those few minutes when he got born and Dean went in, or was it Sam that went in, whichever one went in, he aged. So that'll be interesting. And that creepy smile, I don't know if it's going to be good. Although that could be just a way of throwing us off and making us think that he's evil. In the next episode, it could be good. Because obviously, well, Cass is dead now. I was going to say, they'll want to honour what they said to the mother. But I suppose Sam and Dean didn't really say it. And it was Cass that made the promise of protecting the Nephilim and raising it. Sam and Dean wanted to take the grace. It'll be interesting anyway. I do hope it's not just a clear-cut he's evil thing, you know? I'd like something different. Like something like this season. This season, for me, structurally, was very, very different, and that's one of the main reasons why I enjoyed it so much. So I liked that. So something like dealing with an alternate universe and having a Nephilim there. I hope they don't just sideline the alternate universe. I hope that gets like brought into it more next season. Explore it more and whatnot. So there's a lot of opportunities for next season to be structurally very different again. So hopefully they do. I was really hoping Bobby would cross over with him and help him fight Lucifer, but no, I hope that is just a tease for next season, and that if they do explore that alternate universe, that Bobby could be like their guide. He could be like the one, because he's their contact over there now, you know, if they do eventually get over there. So he could be like their main guy over there. That would be very interesting. Hopefully. As I said, it's a perfect opportunity to bring back loads of old characters. Like you have Joe, Ellen, Rufus, Bobby. Fucking it'd be such a great opportunity to bring them back. Even just for small cameos or for like one or two episode arcs would be fine. Just to see him again. It's such a good opportunity to do that. So hopefully we get that. I do want to see more Mary. I'm glad they didn't kill her off, but I hope that that's just not a sideline. I don't think it is. I think introducing something as big as that in the finale it wasn't just a way to get rid of Lucifer and Mary. I think they will delve into it more next season. They could, if the Nephilim does turn out to be good, or it starts out good, like it could start out good and then he turns or whatever. But if he does start out good, they could try and get the Nephilim to use his power to reopen the portal. I mean, if the Nephilim did it already, I know it was due to his birth, but if the Nephilim did do it once, whether it was by accident or by design or whatever, it could do it again. It has the power. So, hopefully. I don't really have a whole lot more. Like, the season as a whole, I thought was very good. It was different. It was, it kept a few things fresh, and it just structurally, it felt very different and it flowed differently. It was a nice change of pace from the usual Supernatural formula. For me, it was one of the best seasons for a while. I've liked every season of Supernatural. Some obviously were a little bit rough, like season 6 and 7, I think, were a little bit rough just because they came off this big epic storyline of seasons 1 to 5, like with this big epic storyline with hell and heaven and all this, and the apocalypse and fighting Lucifer. So they kind of had to find their footing again, and I think starting from season 8 onwards is where they started to slowly bring the quality back up. And for this season for me was up there with the old seasons. It was very good. I just thoroughly enjoyed it. The only thing I'm disappointed with this season would be Mick getting killed off. I thought, my hope was that, and I did think it as well, I thought they were going to eventually bring Mick over to the Hunter side, over to Sam and Dee's side, and have him be like a little side character in that world, like Cass or Bobby or Rufus that pops up every now and again and helps. And then he gets shot in the back of the head. It needed to happen because it solidified how bad the British metal letters were and how much they don't, like, they're just all about rules and they're basically just brainwashed robots. And it made us realize how bad Ketch was, you know? So they kind of needed to do it. But I liked Mick, and I liked that as the season was going on and as he was hanging around with Sam and Dean, he was slowly sympathizing more with the cases they were doing and the people they were saving and all that, and he was slowly like becoming one of them basically. And fucking Ketch just executes him. Fucking Ketch. So yeah, season 12 is done. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for watching all the episodes this season. We obviously didn't start at the start. We started like about episode 17, 16 or something like that. Next season I will be starting at the start. I will be doing more. I might not be doing them live if they do come. I don't know yet, just because we'll have The Flash, Legends of Tomorrow, Walking Dead, Arrow, and a few more. Like, I'll be doing all them live and I'll be fucking swamped with all of them. So I may not do Supernatural live. I may do what I did here and sideline it until one of them shows go down or go on break or whatever, and I can start doing them then. I'll see. I don't know. If my schedule is good at the time, I might try and do them anyway. So yeah, thank you for watching again. We will be back next week with some more reactions and gaming videos. We'll have them all on the channel during the week. If you want to check them out, we have some social media links and a website address down below in the description if you want to check them out as well. We also have a Discord community channel where we talk about TV shows, movies, games, Not like that, that you can join if you want. The address is on the website as well. You can like, comment, and subscribe if you liked the video. If you didn't, it is all good. And yeah, we'll see you next time. Later.